Regiment from Catterick.
All right.
Years since with that lot. 22 of them this year.
Yeah, I did this car with four cars.
I was with the one you put to Nottingham detachment, Italian medic.
Yeah.
And Sean Phillips, who's now the company commander, he's a young lieutenant, man. Good boy. They all go on parade.
General salute! Present!
Several plus people can be there too.
No.
No.
Still got the green backing on the cap badge.
All right.
Probably down to a quarter what's there when they've done.
All right.
Like one of the four pass, yes. He got a military cross.
Did he?
Yeah. I'm trying to think what his name is now. It's Tim.
Oh, it's
Tim.
Yeah,
tell you what,
we'll
do better than
the serious move. We've stood the front rank to attention.
Yeah.
And then as he goes past, they'll get an order to stand at ease. They're all from the check on
right? They've got a good future if you can get through it.
Fuck the European Army.
Oh, God. Seeing them come out in that battle.
I've got an old fire and old Genesis slot.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's worth it. Remember for good, O God, all past and present members of this regiment. May the defence of the Most High be round us and within us, in our going out and our coming in our rising up and in our going down, in all our days and our nights, until dawn, when the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings for the people of the world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Make its mind up, though, can it? So we come to our moment of remembrance. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us. For your tomorrow, we gave our today. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so as we come to the end of this day, I mentioned Hammy Mooney. Hammy was always here. Latter years he has rode in the jeep rather than marched, and sadly he passed away this year. We remember Hammy. He was a founder member, one of the founder members of the Chesterfield branch of the PRA. And he was a real character, loved by many people in this country and abroad. I always made it my point at the branch meetings, if anything went wrong, it was Hammy's fault. And then I always remembered at the end of the evening, for Hammy especially, that I heard confessions on Friday. We had a wonderful relationship, and he will be missed greatly. Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Rest now in peace. And our final blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and always. Amen.
Is it morning still? Good afternoon, everybody. If I could just say a few things before the parade finishes. Firstly, thank you to you all for turning up. You know, one of those life lessons, certainly worth remembering, is never forget where you came from. And for airborne forces, this is where it came from. This is where airborne forces collectively and individually were formed. And that is why this is such a special place. Quite extraordinary to have. I was talking to the Red Devils, and in the Red Devils, just in that small team, there was a guy who was doing his first public jump, not his first parachute jump, thankfully, but his first public display. One of the display team was in his 22nd year in the army, and the guy on the right had just been promoted from private to Lance Corporal. So there is kind of three extraordinary mini stories, and they were there in front of the guy who I walked over to lay the wreath with. And just let me tell you, most of you will know, but just let me remind you of that little story. It's not a little story, it's a significant one. So that was Sapper Tom Hicks, Royal Engineers. In 1939, he decided to join the army before the war had broken out, and stayed in. He joined the Royal Engineers, came here and did his airborne training, spent 6 months here, then went up to Ringway and learned how to parachute. He then did three operational parachute jumps. He jumped into North Africa, he jumped into Sicily, and then he jumped into Arnhem. And he was captured at Arnhem. The guy sat next to him, Sergeant Len Atto, was captured after his Sicily parachute jump. He's just this year, he'll be getting a letter from the Queen. He will be 100 years old in August. Len will be 100 next February, so he will look forward to getting his letter from the Queen. And I was talking to it sounds a bit strange calling him Tom, sir. I was talking to him, and he did his last parachute jump with the Red Devils at 73 years old. He decided to write a book 2 years ago. I think it's titled Captured at Arnhem, if I get the title right. But anyway, as he tells me, it's available on Amazon. So there's a shameless plug for what I'm sure, and I'm gonna order it this afternoon. I'm sure it is an amazing book. And I said, so what keeps you? You saw how sprightly he was, kind of. I was trying to keep up with him on the walk back. And he says, well, he plays a bit of tennis still. And he says he doesn't play so well now, but he makes it bloody difficult for those who do play well, who are his opponents. And that, to me, those two stories, at a place like this, where they both came through, where a kind of sense of comradeship and purpose has been so important in my life, this is where it started, and that's why I'm here. And thank you for supporting the regiment. And there, with the green backs to their cap badges, are the next generation of the parachute regiment. These are young soldiers of all different previous experiences and ages, but they've got one thing in common: they want to be paratroopers, and they're in training, and they'll turn out, I hope, in the next few months, and they'll go off around the world on operation. We've got serving members of four power, and the best manned, most productive, most able, most capable, most operationally experienced reserve part of the army. And then we've got the veterans on our right. So this is a big deal. This is an important place, and thank you all for just taking a moment out of your Sunday to remember who came through here. And in this 75th year of the anniversary of both Normandy and Arnhem, just to give a moment of your time to remember them. Thank you. So, as always, a huge amount of people go to putting this together. Could I just formally thank Councillor Stuart Britton and Mrs. Anne Britton, the Lord Mayor and Mayoress of Chesterfield. I met them here for the first time last year. This was their first civic event, and they'll be handing over shortly, and this will be their last civic event as the Lord Mayor and Mayoress. Thank you very much. We've got the Vice Chair of also the District Council, Councillor Rita Turner, and her husband Ken. As always, huge thanks to General David Jolliffe and his wife Hilary, who are tremendous supporters of, if you like, the Northern chapter of Airborne Forces and the PRA of the Yorkshire region. Just ploughs in so much energy into making these things happen. To Mick Watton and Lisa Turner, as always, the kind of beating hearts behind all of this. To Denise Edwards, the General Manager of the National Trust here, looking after this beautiful building and beautiful grounds, and just as importantly, the legacy of Airborne Forces here, to Claire Hill. And then to the kind of the elements, obviously to Catterick and to ITC, to Lieutenant Colonel Andy Waring, sat behind me to the right, the Commanding Officer of Four Para. Thank you to you. This wouldn't happen without him and his team's support. To the band, just awesome. It's stirring, it's moving, and you're tremendously smart. Thank you. To the Red Devils, I'd never seen that swooping wing suit thing before. So that just looked fantastic, and just they are the epitome of the professionalism and the dedication of the Parachute Regiment and Airborne Forces. To the Parade RSM, W1Q, to Sean, Major Sean Phillips, the OC of the Parade, and I'm sure I've missed somebody out. If I have, I'm sorry, but thank you to everybody that has come together to mark this, particularly this year on the 75th anniversary of those two significant events. So thank you to everybody, and I hope you will enjoy and continue to enjoy your sunny Sunday at this very special place. Thank you.